The Hoverman, the gray Hoverman. A double diamond, a single bay gray Hoverman, has a lot of names. This is a simple build I make. It's very functional. This is one of the best antennas I feel you can build. And what I start with is overall, from here to down here, the backbone is 21 inches. Now between this point right there in the center and this point at the very top, that's 20 inches. You need 10 inches between this element mount and this element mount and this element mount. 10 inches on center. It's beautiful. The wire is number 10 copper. Watch my bending videos. There are two ways to make a bend. On this one, I made the now famous wraparound joint, or the eyelet. And that wraps around that screw. So you have to actually put the screw through it. It has an incredible holding power. The idea is, this is Florida. A regular bend just around a screw can come apart, and it has come apart. A bowline, a connector. This is simple. You can buy them anywhere, almost. There are several different kinds. That is 300 to 75 ohms. Just a UHF, VHF, matching transformer, simple thing. Anyway, back to measurements. The wire, number 10. It starts out 60 inches long. You always leave a little bit of room to bend and make mistakes. These are all right angles on the element. Right angle here, right angle here. Out here, that's a 45. The drawing says 135. Do the math. It's 45 degrees. You're making a 45 degree bend. The backbone is aluminum. That's my favorite material. It's stiff. It doesn't rust. It holds up. Like I said, it's overall, it's 21 inches in length. You need 10 inches between bays, and that extra half inch on each end gives you something to mount your insulator to. The space between here, on this it's 1 3/4 of an inch. Some are 1.5 inches. It's not exactly critical, but it's important. Some antennas require a lot of space, some don't. The engineers who make the plans will tell you. Hello. Hello. It stopped. Anyway, this is the Hoverman. I've mounted it on a backbone for the reflector grid. These are 1/4 inch bolts. They're 4 inches long. And I just use that to separate the two. You need 4.5 inches between a Hoverman element and a reflector grid, whatever you choose for a grid. This grid, I said before, is 16 gauge galvanized steel. It's very stiff. I camfer the edges a little bit on both sides to give it a little more stiffness in the wind. Not that it catches a lot of wind, but you don't want something that's going to be flopping around. It's going to interfere with your signals. The reflector is 29 by 36. The reflector backbone is 36. this is basically a UHF antenna. It'll also pick up high VHF. High being channel 8, channel 9, channel 10, up that range. Maybe higher. We don't have VHF here, so it's difficult for me to experiment or judge or to do anything. We don't have any. But it's a nice antenna. And you can build this very solid. It'll receive channels out to 50. If you push it hard, 60. If you have a really clear view, maybe 60 miles. You're not going to get any further. You really aren't. Don't expect to build a 200-mile antenna. It's not going to happen. The Earth curves. You'd have to put it 1,600 feet in the air to try to compensate. But that's the Gray Hoverman. Very simple. Start out 21 inches long. Keep 10 inches between your bays. Make your element. Start with 60 inches of... I use solid copper or use aluminum. Or you're not going to find a 60-inch coat hanger. Don't try to make sections. It has to be continuous. It has to be continuous. You feed from the center. You put your bell in the center. Most antennas feed from the center. It's a very good antenna. Highly recommend it. A fairly simple build. You don't have to have a reflector. The reflector makes it directional. If you choose not to have a reflector and just put it up, you can get signals from both sides. You won't receive anything from the side. That's a dead spot, the two sides. And I say it has 170 forward view because of the dead spots on the sides. There you go.